Hello friends, welcome to Smart Catalyst. Today we'll be seeing the prelims current affairs of 31st January 2019. There are 5 articles we'll be seeing today for prelims. These 5 are: first one is about obesity. It's about a Lancet report which talks about urban planning and its relationship with good health. Second article talks about the geographical concept of polar vortex and which has led to very low temperature in United States of America. Third article we'll be seeing is about MNREGA and the wages associated with the scheme. And the fourth article is about a study on cow urine and global warming. And the final article talks about National Statistical Commission. The first article we'll be seeing is, are our cities making us obese? Lancet report on urban planning key to good health. This article was taken from the New Indian Express. So we all know that globally the impact of obesity, that is overweight, has overtaken the negative impacts caused by malnutrition. Though malnutrition is still the most important factor affecting the developing and underdeveloped countries, obesity has overtaken the malnutrition in case of developed countries. So in this light, a recently released Lancet survey highlights the importance of obesity and the measures needed to tackle this problem. The report says that the way our environments are built and the lands are used and the laws which are framed, it has profound impact on our health. So this report correlates the laws framed in our land with the health. So the report also talks about the interplay between 3 important factors, namely obesity, undernutrition and climate change. And it also uses a word to showcase this interplay, calling it global syndemic, which is an interplay of 3 epidemics. The report also gives us some valuable data. According to the report, 38% of the kids under the age of 5 are suffering from stunting. So stunting means they are too short for the age. 21% of the children are below the age of 5 are suffering from wasting, which means they are too thin for their age. And 36% of children are undernutrition. This 58% mainly includes women. The report also talks about the increasing impact of non-communicable diseases among the populations globally. It mainly talks about the prevalence of diabetes. In comparison with 1990 to 2016, the prevalence of diabetes globally has increased by about 36%, which makes it a very important non-communicable disease. In case of India, the adult overweight percentage from 1990 to 2016 has increased by about 20%. This is a grave area of concern, as overweight is a very important factor leading to other non-communicable diseases. This report also talks about the climate change, and it says that about 650 million Indians are affected by climate change, and without any proper climate mitigation mechanism, these people's health will be severely affected. So this report takes into consideration 4 main factors, which is agricultural policies, transportation, urban land use and urban land use design, overconsumption and inequalities. So according to the report, these 4 factors, it drives the reasons behind obesity, undernutrition and climate change, which in turn leads to increasing inequalities between the people of the country. The report also talks about bringing in some solutions. The report talks about active transportation, which will lead to increased physical activity, thus giving less sedentary time, which will have impact on decreasing obesity among the adult population. It also paves way for increasing cheaper transport, thereby giving healthier food opportunities to the citizens, as well as increasing employment, which will indirectly increase the poverty in our country. If poverty is reduced, definitely undernutrition will also come down. And going on to cleaner transport facilities will reduce the greenhouse gases, which will definitely have a positive impact on bringing down the effects of climate change. So by bringing in these suggestions, it also talks about establishing a framework for food systems in lines with the existing framework for preventing tobacco consumption. Second article for the day is, polar vortex freezes United States of America's Midwest, temperature in Chicago hits sub-zero. This article was taken from Hindu. This article talks about the extremely low temperature to the extent of minus 30 degrees Celsius in the Midwest of United States of America. So a blast of Arctic air from polar vortex has brought this dangerous bone-chilling cold wind to United States. So here for prelims, we have to know about the concept of polar vortex. So what is polar vortex is a potential question in the prelims exam. So what is polar vortex? So polar vortex is extremely low pressure area. This low pressure area exists only in poles, both in North Pole as well as South Pole. So this is North Pole, and polar vortex is low atmospheric pressure in North Pole area. So this, the term vortex is given because this low pressure air mass, it moves in counterclockwise direction. This counterclockwise airflow system keeps the air mass in place above the poles alone. However, when everything is stable, the air mass stays in the above the poles. However, we all know that the seasons change. Because of the frequently changing seasons, there's a change in this air mass also. So this causes frequent weakening as well as regaining the strength of the polar vortex. Especially in the winter season, this polar vortex weakens. Because of the weakening of this polar vortex, it does have serious influence on the countries located in northern part of America. So this picture shows clearly the polar vortex concept. So this is the cold air mass, and the cold air mass is surrounded by jet stream. In ideal condition, the cold low pressure air mass is constant. However, in the winter season, this air mass is weakened, which causes it to wobble and becomes detached from the polar vortex. So this makes the jet stream wobble, and thus the chill air mass comes out of the poles areas, resulting in extremely low temperature in northern parts of America. So this is basically low pressure and high pressure concept. So as we all know, when there is low pressure, there is inward flow of air mass. This is because by nature, low pressure system, they suck the air and everything moves towards the low pressure. However, in case of high pressure, the air moves out of high pressure area towards the low pressure area. So when the low pressure here is disturbed, especially due to factors such as increasing temperature attributed to climate change, this polar vortex is affected by high pressure systems, thus making the air come out of the polar vortex. So this chill air causes minus 30 degrees Celsius in northern parts of America. Third article for the day is, states may have to fund for MNREGA wages. This article was taken from Hindu. This article talks about MNREGA scheme, that is Mahatma Gandhi Rural Employment Guarantee Act scheme. So the news here is that the states are struggling to pay the workers in this MNREGA scheme, and they have received additional funds from the center to meet their pending liabilities. However, this additional funding is also not sufficient, and they are soon likely to run out of this money this financial year. They may also be pushed to a situation wherein they will have to use their own funds, that is state funds, to run the scheme. So here you have to know about what is MNREGA scheme. So this MNREGA scheme is a scheme which was brought in the year 2005. So this scheme provides 100 days of employment in every financial year for every adult member in any rural household who is willing to do unskilled job. And for this unskilled job, like manual work, they will be paid statutory minimum wages. So this program is implemented by Ministry of Rural Development in association with the various state governments in our country. Since this is a grassroots level program, the participation of Gram Panchayats plays a very important role in this. Apart from guaranteeing right to work, which indirectly leads to right to live with dignity, as per Article 21 of Indian Constitution, this MNREGA also plays a very important role in establishing gender equality and also gender empowerment. About 50% of the work under the scheme must be provided to women, which leads to empowerment of women. There's also provision of social audit under the scheme so that the scheme is implemented in a transparent and accountable manner. The work, the manual unskilled work under the scheme includes agriculture and allied activities, construction of sanitation facilities, as well as flood management, watershed and other irrigation and livestock related work. However, nationally, this scheme is now seeing negative balance of about 4,000 crores. The Rural Ministry has also called for an additional allocation of about 5,000 crores in order to implement this right to work scheme. The worst sufferers in this scheme include states of West Bengal, Madhya Pradesh and Karnataka. The next article we'll be seeing is, the study says cow urine may be a reason for global warming. This article was also taken from Hindu. This article talks about a research work on cow urine. So cow urine, we all know its importance of cow and cow urine in our country. It is a minor font of research in India for its medicinal benefits. However, though it contributes to medicinal benefit, it also leads to global warming according to the recently conducted study in the countries of Colombia, Argentina, Brazil, Nicaragua, Trinidad and Tobago, and it's recently published the results. According to the result, cow urine contains high traces of nitrous oxide, that is N2O. So this N2O is a greenhouse gas. And its global warming potential is very, very high when compared to other global warming gases such as carbon dioxide. So this its global warming potential is almost 300 times more powerful than carbon dioxide itself. So it will definitely so this has high potential to increase the temperature of Earth, thus leading to climate change. So the research says that this nitrous oxide is mainly released by cattle, which contributes to about 42% of the nitrous oxide, followed by buffalo, goats and sheep, which also release a significant amount of nitrous oxide to the atmosphere. The research also adds that this release of nitrous oxide, when it is used in degraded pastures as manures, the emission of N2O is almost tripled, which further increases the global warming. This is because it is common practice in our country that dung and urine are mixed together and used as a manure for Indian fields. Apart from this manuring, cattle and livestock are also significant sources of release of methane, which is also a greenhouse gas. So both these problems are combined together in our country. The study also warns that this increase in carbon dioxide will definitely have a negative impact on food security of our country if this is not corrected, as about 50% of Indian population is still employed in agriculture and our agricultural system is already under severe strain. The livelihood of farmers must be taken into consideration and this issue must be addressed according to the research. The final topic for the day is about National Statistical Commission and the members of National Statistical Commission's resignation. This article is taken from Hindu. So this article talks about National Statistical Commission. This National Statistical Commission is the executive body under the Ministry of Statistics. This body, which ideally consists of 4 persons, was currently functioning with only 2 members, and the 2 final members also resigned 2 days back. So here we have to know about the National Statistical Commission for prelims. So this National Statistical Commission was established via a resolution. So this is not a statutory body, it is just a body created via a resolution. So this body was created in the year 2005. This body was set up based on recommendations of a commission specifically set up for this purpose, headed by Rangarajan. And the main function of this body is to evolve policies, priorities and standards in various statistical matters with respect to India. This body consists of 4 members plus 1 chairperson. These 4 members and the chairperson must have specialization and experience in statistical field. There are organizations like CSO, Central Statistical Office, and National Sample Survey Organization in our country, which face serious problems in collecting data from state as well as central governments. So umbrella body called NSO, that is National Statistical Commission, was established so that they can coordinate between the collection of data between the various other statistical bodies in our country. This will also ensure that the data collected is unbiased. Currently, the position of all 4 members in this commission is vacant.